It's AumSum time.
What is BMI?
Burger with mango ice cream.
Nah. BMI stands for Body Mass Index. It is used to check whether we have a healthy weight according to our height. BMI is calculated by dividing a person's weight in kilograms with his height in meters squared. A BMI of 18.49 or below indicates that the person is underweight. 18.5 to 24.99 is considered as normal weight. 25 to 29.99 overweight, and a BMI of 30 or more is considered as obese. Thus, BMI helps doctors to categorize our overall health. However, some experts think that this method is not accurate. Why? Because BMI doesn't distinguish between fat and muscle mass. So, for example, if a person has more well-defined muscle mass and less fat levels, BMI will categorize him as obese. Also, a person having less muscle mass and more amount of harmful visceral fat may be considered healthy by BMI. Lastly, BMI doesn't even take into account an individual's age, gender, etc. What is blood pressure?
It's a form of acupressure.
Nah. In order to deliver oxygen and nutrients to each and every cell of our body, our heart pushes blood through tubes called blood vessels. As the blood moves, it exerts force on the vessel's walls. The measurement of this force of blood on the walls is called blood pressure. The ideal blood pressure reading is about 120 over 80 millimeters of mercury or slightly below it. But why does the reading have two numbers? It is because our heart is constantly contracting and relaxing. During a phase called systole, our heart contracts to push the blood through arteries, thus increasing the pressure. So, the bigger number indicates the systolic blood pressure. Whereas during diastole, our heart relaxes, decreasing the pressure. So, the smaller number indicates the diastolic blood pressure. What is the science behind acupressure?
It's not science, dude. It's geography.
Nah. Acupressure emerged from traditional Chinese medicine theory. The theory states that there are about 12 major meridians or channels in our body. Vital energy or life force called qi flows through these channels. And a block in the flow leads to discomfort, pain, or diseases. Hence, to release the blockages, practitioners apply pressure on specific acupoints present along the channels to promote healing. Although it is not proved yet, experts say that acupressure does reduce pain. How? When we eat painkillers, they stimulate specific pathways in the brain, helping reduce the pain. According to experts, the force on acupoints does the same. In addition to this, a study on rats showed that acupressure actually reduced the activity in their brain's stress pathways. So, in humans, it might work in a similar manner. However, many other experts think that it is just a placebo effect. What is vocal fry?
It may be similar to a French fry.
Not at all. Vocal fry is a creaky or raspy voice seldom used in speech.
I thought it is used by leech.
Oh, gross. Just throw that away and listen. When we speak, air from our lungs passes through the vocal folds, making them vibrate. These vibrations make the air in our mouth and nose to vibrate, thus producing sound or voice. Generally, human voice can be divided into three ranges or registers. They are falsetto, modal, and fry. Most people speak and sing in the modal range. But sometimes, when we speak in fry range, our vocal folds slam shut. However, longitudinally, they are not stretched tightly. Air from the lungs bubbles out through this loosely closed folds, thus creating that creaky voice called fry.